What's up, everybody? Welcome to Ask Rindy. I'm Rindy Adebayo, digital entrepreneur, real estate entrepreneur, and top producing real estate agent here in New Jersey. And welcome to Ask Rindy. If it's your first time on my channel, please hit the subscribe button and smash the like button. I do videos about foreclosure, income, and credit, and I would love to have you as a part of our growing network all around the country. Also, we're currently pre-enrolling for Foreclosure Hacks Academy, so click the link below to get started today. So, hurricane foreclosures. We're currently in the middle of hurricane season right now, which runs here in the U.S. from June 1st to November 30th. And right now, the current hurricane that everyone's talking about is Hurricane Dorian. And I believe right now it's currently pounding down on South Carolina. It's expected to either touch down or has actually touched down already after leaving widespread devastation in the Bahamas just a few days ago. Now, the thing about the hurricane is that every year we have this same problem during the season. These hurricanes and these cyclones form, and they form devastation. They come in, they touch down on land, and there are different headlines that fly around. Some of them are based around the amount of damage that they've caused. Some of them are based around the size. It seems like they're growing every year. They're getting worse and worse. But the thing about it is that this is something that we live with. Every year we have hurricane season. It's something that we have grown accustomed to seeing, understanding, and expecting. What people don't talk about, though, every year is the fact that hurricanes also leave behind a widespread damage and a widespread net of foreclosures. Every year, many foreclosures are created, or what we call hurricane foreclosures are created, and also weather-related storms. This is something that most headlines don't talk about, the damage and the after effect of what the hurricanes do, not only pre-hurricane, but also post-hurricane, and especially after the hurricane touches down. So you have a combination of two of the worst things that can ever happen to a person. You have the hurricane and the storms on one hand that cause displacement, uncertainty, homelessness, death, and also pretty much a life interruption. Every year, the names of the hurricanes change, but the devastation is still the same. They leave widespread damage, they leave life interruption, and also cause widespread foreclosures. So we're currently dealing with Dorian, but there's been Hurricane Andrew, there's been Katrina, there's been Maria, some of the worst storms in history, in U.S. history. And worst of all, these hurricanes and these storms make situations that are bad even worse, because they're putting people in the place of displacement. They're causing people to have to move from their state to other states. They're causing a situation where they can't, their jobs that they have currently where they are, the jobs are wiped out. Their whole life is turned upside down, and they have families. You know, they still have to pay a mortgage. So I have two quick small tips that I want to give you if you're in a hurricane foreclosure or if you're in a weather-related foreclosure currently. Number one, always get three insurance options. And I like you to do this prior to the hurricane. So I know many of us that live in these states, we know that our states are prone to weather patterns, hurricanes, etc. And a lot of times we'll lock in with an insurance company. And you know, with that insurance, they'll tell you what coverage you have, what they're willing to offer as far as flood insurance, etc. But then some of them have policies where they'll tell you, well, we can't cover hurricanes. And so what I always want to encourage my clients to do is to always have three options. You want three insurance companies, and you want to basically get their policies. Specifically with homeowners insurance, you want to be able to have three options to be able to choose from. What I recommend is you contact them and basically find out what they're offering as far as coverage and get an estimate. In addition to that, I want you to sign up for their alerts. Make sure you sign up, because although the insurance has criteria and they'll tell you what their policies are, sometimes in the situation, in the emergency, they're forced to change those things. They're forced to make revisions to be able to allow for the damage and to be able to allow people who actually have the policies. Also, you want to find out about any state-run insurance policies that you can sign up for and find out if they can help you or add to your coverage and protection. In addition to that, you want to sign up for the National Flood Insurance Program, and I'm going to leave a link below so that you can contact them directly. And when I'm talking about this, I'm talking about not only homeowners insurance, but I'm talking about home, your personal property insurance, and also auto. You want to get three quotes for all three. It's very important. This is a key, because you want to be able to compare changes that are happening. You might have a certain policy and a certain standard, a certain premium that you're paying right now, but based on the situation and the change with the storm, your competitor to your current company might have a better rate. You always want to be shopping, so you want to have those three options on standby, so that actually once you start to look into it, you can see and compare apples to apples and see if you're in a worse situation or if you have a better opportunity elsewhere. Now, obviously, we're talking about the National Flood Insurance Program, that's something that you actually have to pay for. So just imagine being in the situation where you're dealing with a hurricane, you have so much fear, and not only that, but you're displaced. I mean, I don't know if you guys have ever been displaced, but it's the most horrible feeling ever, because you're in a situation where you're out of your home, you are somewhere where you don't want to be, probably a shelter or a family member's house if you're fortunate. And not only that, you're really displaced because you're not even working. You know, maybe you have a situation where your job is where the hurricane happened. Everything is shut down. You know, people have been evacuated. So if you don't have money coming in, that's a real deterrent, because what happens basically is that you're in a situation now where you still have a mortgage, you're still on the hook for the mortgage. And that's why I'm doing this video. I want to be able to give you these preparation tips. So number two would be, you definitely need to contact your mortgage company and ask them for a forbearance agreement pre-hurricane. You want to make certain steps. You want to be able to deal with the insurance, and then you also want to contact your mortgage company and ask them to send you the paperwork and send you the package to be able to initiate a forbearance agreement prior to the hurricane. So having the forbearance agreement actually in hand and actually having it queued to be able to turn it into the mortgage company should in case you need to is very important, because like I've always shared with you guys here on my channel, a forbearance basically what it does is it sets aside the current mortgage payment obligation. And what it does is it gives you time with a preset or a post-dated date where you're going to actually start to actually activate and make those payments again. I do go into detail regarding weather-related foreclosures and also things like hurricane foreclosures, storm foreclosures, in Foreclosure Hacks, our course on foreclosures. So you can actually check more details out there. But regarding forbearance is very important, because what happens a lot of times with the hurricanes and the storms, they're going to position you where they're really going to basically interrupt your life. That means not only your personal life, your home, but also your job, your work. You're not going to be leaving a homeless shelter and getting dressed up and then going to work. It doesn't work. And especially in a situation where your work is actually in the same place where your home is that's been affected by the hurricanes. Evacuations, resetting up the city and the town where you live, it takes time. Many times people don't talk about the after effect of a hurricane, but it could take years. As we all know, people are still affected and still reeling from the effects of Hurricane Katrina. Maria just happened in 2017, so there's a lot of people that are still affected by it. I have personal friends that are actually still reeling from the loss and devastation of Hurricane Maria in Puerto Rico. So having these two things set, your homeowners insurance, both on your home specifically, your personal property covering it, and also your auto insurance, because as we all know, cars get flooded and you need your car to be able to move around. And so these are my two quick tips to be able to help you if you're currently in a hurricane foreclosure or if you're in a weather-related foreclosure currently. And if you're in those situations and you need further help, we have two hacks that I'd like to share with you, and I want to show you how to completely turn around your situation for good if you're in a situation where you're facing foreclosure and you're in a hurricane foreclosure or you have been affected by that. In addition to that, we want to show you how we implement moratoriums and how we actually maneuver the mortgage companies to be able to play ball. So with that being said, if you need help, please feel free to reach out to us. Also, if you need to learn about foreclosure, income, and credit, make sure you join Foreclosure Hacks Academy. Click the link below to get started today. And until next time, thank you guys for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Oh,